Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Thanks for joining me today. I'm talking about an all-important facial angle. Someone had asked about a video I did prior, which was Get Facial Angles, Get Famous. And we're talking about fame and fortune and how people who tend to do more of these treatments are famous, or as they get famous, they have the money to do more. Which comes first? The Instagram models and social media, the whole gamut. And it was an angle of the face that I talked about. And one of the things we've been talking about a lot on this channel, morphometrics, and the study of how somebody's face elicits a response, the higher cheek, the front of the cheek, the size of the lips, all in coordination with the motor movement, the expression, and even how they move their hands, or the expression of the body and how people carry themselves. So I wanted to revisit that angle and explain it a little bit more, but it's one of the most important angles that we look on the face in males and females, not only for beauty, but also for masculinity, for femininity, for identity, and it even plays a role in the success of people. But most importantly, I bring it up when I'm talking lip filler and the chin projection, and how when we're doing lip fillers, we have to really think about the chin and the jawline and make sure it's congruent, because you can't put lips on a convex face and accentuate the forward look of the lips if the chin and jawline are retracted. So I'm talking about that angle today. It's a Raji's Quick Clip. We're getting started in 3 seconds. Okay, so the line we're talking about is the nasion to the chin line. And I'm gonna show you some examples of people who have it. And I want you to think about the famous stars or those people that you think are attractive or that have a certain look. And look at this angle that I'm talking about and see if they have it, see if it's strong, see if it's weak, and see what your reaction to it is. So the nasion to the chin, let's go through it. Remember, if you like these videos, click like, subscribe. It helps me do more of these and helps our metrics of our channel. And always remember, there's a search bar, so you can search. A lot of people say, oh, we're talking about nasion to chin. What about chin fillers? Search within my channel, chin fillers, and several videos will come up. You'll be able to watch the procedures being done. We're not just talking about it here, we're applying it. And that's the difference with the channel, it's education. But morphometrics, the study of lines and evolution, is something very fascinating and the response to it. Let's dive in and look at a couple faces. I think it's gonna be the easiest way for you to understand, but this angle is what your injector's thinking of. It's what your physician or your provider's thinking of when they're thinking about, oh, I want lip filler. Oh, you want chin projection. Oh, you want a strong bigonial width. Or even when we think of eyes, definitely noses. Let's dive in, I'll show you what I'm talking about. So if we take Angelina, the nasion here to the chin, now she's tilted kind of forward, kind of, she's tilted in this direction. But if you can imagine, she, even if tilted forward like she is with her neck, obviously has a strong jawline, a strong gonial angle here. We can't see her bigonial width because we'd have to see the other side. But if you think about it and you look, and what would her angle be? It's pretty much straight down. And that's an acceptable angle. It's kind of, it's very attractive angle for her. When she has her chin up, it's actually on a positive cant. But in this picture, even with her not being perfect, you can kind of see point one, point two, and a positive direction from neutral. So that would be your angle right here. Okay, that would be your angle. Why that's important, particularly look at her lips and her lip projection, okay? So her chin is strong enough, but let's say someone like this comes in and wants chin filler. Well, you could create more positive. Let's say if it was negative and the chin was retracted here, and a whole discussion of the jawline is going to be important. We'll dive into it at some point, but just chewing and dentition, one thought to give you here is, one is, we take teeth out when we put braces in, with our kids, okay? That retracts the jawline back. Another thought is that when we chew, okay, chewing creates a strong jawbone. Years and years ago when we had to chew things that like bones and animals, we developed more bone and we had stronger jawlines here. And now because of the softer diets of our kids and soft food that they eat, you don't get a development here of the jawline. But that's a whole nother discussion. Let's go and look at another picture so I can demonstrate that angle to you. Okay, Carmen Electra. Okay, if you think, here's our point, our two points. Again, she's slightly tilted forward, but it's a neutral to positive. It's not retracted in that angle. It's not far forward, although far forward is more accepted as long as there isn't an underbite and it fits the dentition. And you can see a nice straight nose, but if she's getting lip filler, you have to consider the chin and the nasion to chin and also the AE line. Another one good to study, the AE line, so that we know where the chin is relative to the nose. A bigger nose would change that AE line in a negative direction. And opposite, a smaller nose or a defect in the chin or a smaller chin would change it so that you can't. You wouldn't want to create larger lips or they become what? Ducky. Let's go to another picture. Okay, my all-time favorite, Dua Lipa. Okay, if we take a point from the nasion, again, down through the chin, it's neutral to positive. Okay, it's not... Here would be neutral. It's the chin is more forward. Okay, again, strong jawline, strong gonial angle. In real life, I don't think as strong as what this picture's showing. Obviously, there's a shadow created here. Pictures are extremely important, of course. But someone coming in, look at that lip projection. That's what people want. That flipped up lip flip that can be done with threads. Okay, you can put threads in. You can also do neuromodulator at those points I'm showing you right here. But again, the AE line, all important, but if you look at the nasion to chin in my get facial angles, I go through that. It's important, and you can see on her face, she has a great angle. Dua, again, same thing, nasion to chin, positive angle, not retracted. And again, nice lip projection. That's why it's all important, and you can look at the nose and then the rickets, the AE line, okay? So it's all important to have that angle, and it's one of the most attractive, important angles when you consider any aesthetic procedure. Let's go look and even see one more. Here's another picture. You see Jessica Alba. Strong jawline. Look at the chin projection relative to the nasion up here, okay? Positive. Okay, look at the nose. Again, the AE line. Now, you see there are common denominators in the stars of the world. Look at the lip. It's not retracted. Okay, it's not flat. It's rather flipped. And that's an attractive look. Just like color, just like the red color is an attractive feature indicating what? Hormones, okay? And fertility. And that's the thought that makes it attractive, and that's why something like PlasmaLip, where you take your own PRF, is something I like to do. Look at also, one thing we can see here, so we have chin projection, we have a strong submentum, there's no fat here, but also if you want to see an important angle other than that nasion to chin, it would certainly be the ergotrid, the area above the lip. And there is a golden ratio here, which I do like. I don't like them all, but if you draw a line through the lip, and then you look at the area above here and below here, that does nicely fit 1.61 to 1, meaning this should be 1, the area above, and this should be 1.61. And I do like to look at that because what happens as we age this ergotrid, the lip comes over, and it grows. And that's why a lip lift has become common. You're either born with it, or if it's short, she's young, if it's short, you can see it here, it will likely lengthen as she ages. And what happens? She can take that. She will be fine with that, because in general, it is a little bit short from our 1.61 to 1 golden ratio. So as it lengthens, the only thing you have to worry about is, will this lengthen? And we know that it doesn't necessarily. In fact, what do a lot of women come in and say, they have a horizontal line right here, or what we call a mental meaning jaw crease. Okay, so if you have a mental crease, why? The chin comes up. A lot of women say the only thing that elevated as I age, only thing raising is my chin. And that's why people call it sometimes a witch's chin, okay, because it will elevate, this length gets longer, and in fact, then the illusion with this shorter and this longer, you're going in the wrong direction. You're losing that 1.6 1-to-1 as we age. In her case, we can look forward and we know that that grows, that will lengthen, because why? The piriform aperture, the bone, becomes more hollow. Look at a skull, there's a hollow here where the nose is. As that widens, as that gets larger, this gets longer, and as this comes up, that will still make sense for that golden ratio. So that gives you an idea. We can't really talk much about her cheek. We can't see because we don't have a lot of contrast. But those are some cool angles to look at. And then, of course, we can even go into brow shape. So there you go. I wanted to show you that real quickly, that nasion to chin line, that anterior tilt of the face, if you will. Very important line for beauty. It's one of the most important things we look at, one of the first things we look at. And it's why when your injector comes in the room and sees you, they're only looking in a couple ways. One is straight on. And they're going to walk around and they're going to look at you 90 degrees. And that's why they do it. Thanks for joining me today. Like the video, subscribe if you like them. Stay tuned here to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.